Hi friends, my name is Leah. I am a full-time seller on the Poshmark app. My closet link is linked down in the description below if you want to go check out my closet. Today's video is to show you what lighting I believe is best for every budget, whether that's $0, $5, $40, or $100. Is a light kit out there for every budget, and I just want to show you what I have learned with each of those budgets. Of course, starting at $0, going to $5, going to $50, and what a lot of people like if their lighting budget is $100. You can decide what's best for you and your picture taking for your Poshmark closet. So let's get into the video. If you want to spend $0 on your budget for lighting, the first thing that you've heard before is that you can use natural sunlight. Not direct sunlight, but indirect sunlight where it's not shining directly onto an item, but it's kind of filtered either by clouds or maybe by a window, and you just have that beautiful day sunlight. Then the secondary option, if you want to go with the $0 lighting budget, is to simply adjust the brightness on your phone, whether you have an iPhone or a Samsung Galaxy. Now on Apple products, you can focus and then adjust the brightness. You can see it getting brighter there. The white is really bright, and I can also make it pretty dark. So I want it brighter, so I'm just gonna brighten it up. I learned a tip from Thrifty Michelle, which I will link her closet and Instagram down in the description below as well. Samsung Galaxy, you can swipe left, go into pro mode, and it will automatically brighten up any white background that you have. And I love that feature because you can just use the daylight, edit the brightness on, I use a Samsung Galaxy. You can also do it on an Apple product. I love going in and adjusting the brightness on whatever device you're using. Just making it a little bit brighter makes the item pop a little bit more. Let's talk about if you have a $5 budget. If you want to spend $5 on lighting or lighting supplies, the first thing that I would recommend would be to buy the app VSCO. I love that app so much, and it allows you to go in and alter the picture not only with brightness but also contrasting. You preset filters. I stay away from those. I just go right into the editing, brighten it up a little bit. Sometimes with brightening up a picture, it fades the color, and it allows you to keep, having that app allows you to keep the color of the item just by contrasting it, and then you can brighten it up also with the brightness and the exposure. So I love that app. I think it's $1.99. I use it all the time for my pictures, especially my modeled shots. Sometimes this background behind me isn't bright enough, so I go into VSCO and I just brighten up the background, and that really helps with my pictures. And that's the app VSCO. And another $5 option is to make your own photo box, and you can find DIY videos on YouTube about making your own photo box. Usually it involves some type of a white tissue paper and cardboard, and you just basically make a box with cardboard and white tissue paper, and then you put lights. I like this light. It's a white light compared to a warm light. White lights have a brighter appeal. The warm lights are those kind of yellow lights, which I try to stay away from. But if you have $5 and you want to get a white light bulb and do a DIY photo box, you can do that. I'll link a couple of DIY photo box videos down in my description as well, so you can kind of go check that out. But $5 also is a really good investment. If you can't list at night, if you can't list during the day, you can then list at night with a white light bulb and a DIY photo box, which will cost about $5 to make. The option is the $40 range option, and that is currently what I'm using. These umbrella lights, really adjustable, and they have the white light bulb and they have an umbrella which helps to disperse the light, so it prevents shadows. I really love these lights, especially for listing at night. I use a small room that's all white. This is the room that I usually list in, and just having a white room really helps with dispersing the light And I've tried listing in rooms that might be a little bit darker. That does hurt the picture just slightly, but if you do have an adjustable brightness on your phone, or if you're using the VSCO app, you can adjust the brightness. And sometimes I use a combination of both adjusting the brightness and my umbrella lights. But I really love these. These are about $40. I bought these off of Amazon and I will link them down in the description below. Final item that a lot of people really love having, but a lot of people don't have the budget for it, is the $100 lighting. And those are the box lights. I know a lot of people really love the box lights. And that's where you have a filtered white light bulb that has a white sheet between the light bulb and your product, and then a black covering on all the sides except for whatever you're shining that light on. So it is a focused bright light, but a lot of people, but if you don't have the budget for it, you can go with one of the other options. I like doing a combination of some of the others, whether it's just sunlight and using my VSCO app, whether it's just umbrella lighting and using my brightness adjuster on my phone. Those all help really well. Here's a few pictures of the same product in different lighting. So you can just kind of compare the different lighting that I've mentioned here. And the first one is going to be just the natural sunlight. And then I'm going to show you the sunlight with the adjusted brightness on my phone. And those are the free options. Next, I'm going to show you the picture that used the VSCO app to adjust the brightness and the contrast of the colors in my photo. So there's that. And then the next photo is my umbrella lighting in without any sunlight. And the umbrella lighting is really perfect if you're listing at night. And then I'm going to show you the umbrella lighting with the brightness exposure on my phone, so you can see that. And then I don't have any of the boxed lights, but I know a lot of people really love the boxed lights because it's focused and you don't have to worry about adjusting things as much. All the different budgets of lighting that I have seen and that I have used, and I like all of them and they all seem to work pretty well. Let me know what you like to use for lighting down in the comments below. I'd love to hear if you guys have any tips or tricks that you'd like to share with me. Check out my most recent haul up here, and if you'd like to subscribe, you can click this button right here. Bye!